Hi friends, I am Sajitanya. Welcome to SciTech Guru. In this video, I am going to compare the build quality between all the smartphones which I am having right now. The Huawei Y9 Prime, Redmi Note 8 Pro, Redmi K20 Pro, and the Honor 9X and the Realme X device. Do check the links in description for the playlist which includes a lot of comparison videos between all these devices. So don't forget to check the playlist. So recently I ordered the Redmi Note 8 Pro of white color. So to make it look different colors, so that's why I ordered different colors for each smartphone. Green, white, red, and both are blue. Honor 9X and the Realme X device. So don't forget to comment below guys, which is your favorite color and which is a very good looking device. So now let me talk about the build quality of all the smartphones. So in the headphone jack, as you can see, in the all the smartphones it has a headphone jack. And all the phones except the Redmi K20 Pro, where headphone jack is present at the top side, not the bottom side. So this is the one thing to be noted. And the Redmi K20 Pro and the Note 8 Pro has a LED notification light. So there is no LED notification light in the other smartphones, other three phones. So, and the Redmi K20 Pro and the Realme X has a in-display fingerprint scanner. So whereas the other three smartphones has a physical fingerprint scanner at the back side. And then the Honor 9X, there is a fingerprint scanner at the power button. As you can see here, the Redmi Note 8 Pro has a silver coated color in the side, as you can see here. I'm not sure how long it's gonna withstand the usage. So there are more chances of attracting the ink marks on the Redmi Note 8 Pro, so you need to be very careful. So as you can see in the K20 Pro, it attracts a lot of fingerprints, so even with the Honor 9X device. But there's a good thing with the phone is that there is a lot of color shifting in these devices. K20 Pro, Honor 9X and the Realme X device. So when you tilt the phone sideways, so even the Realme X attracts a lot of fingerprints, as you can see here clearly. So whereas the Note 8 Pro doesn't attract much fingerprints. So even it attracts, it won't be that much visible when compared with the other devices. And the main good thing with the Redmi Note 8 Pro is that it has got IR blaster included, which is not present in all the four phones. So which I am very much missing, because in the past I am using the MM Max 3 which has IR blaster. So which is not present in the smartphone guys. So which has they included in the Redmi Note 8 Pro. So even the Redmi Note 8 Pro has got NFC inbuilt in the device. So which is present in the K20 Pro, but not in the other devices, Realme X and the Y9 Prime and the Honor 9X device. So overall, these are the two good things in the Redmi Note 8 Pro device. So considering the mid-range mobile which has a NFC and the IR blaster in the device. So in terms of the expandable storage, the Redmi Note 8 Pro has a hybrid SIM slot. So there are other devices like Realme X and the K20 Pro which doesn't have any expandable storage. So in that case, you need to buy this kind of USB 2-in-1 Type-C pen drive. So where you can easily transfer the data from one phone to other devices. So this is not the case with the Note 8 Pro, Huawei Y9 Prime and the Honor 9X device, which do support the SD card. So in case if your mobile doesn't support any SD card, you need to purchase this kind of extra accessories. So this is the overall comparison between the build quality of the devices. So in terms of the loudspeaker, all the phones are having bottom facing loudspeaker. And I'll be doing definitely a loudspeaker test as well when compared with all the smartphones. So stay tuned guys for that. So all the smartphones are having the weight around 195 grams and 199 grams, except the Honor 9X device, which has a 206 grams. So these are overall in terms of the weight difference between all the devices. So in terms of the build quality and specifications, the Redmi Note 8 Pro has a lot of advantages like IR blaster and 64 megapixel camera with the inclusion of the new lens, a macro lens. So these are the advantages with the Redmi Note 8 Pro. In the future, I'll be doing a lot of camera reviews about the Redmi Note 8 Pro. So stay tuned guys for that. So thank you guys for watching this video. For more videos, subscribe to my channel. So don't forget to check the links in the description for the playlist of videos. See you in the next video. Bye.